What's up, y'all? It's your man, Stephen Bardo, coming at you with another edition of the Flyin' Illini Report. This past week, the Illini fared pretty good. They took care of business at home with a 30-plus point victory over the Minnesota Gophers. Kofi Coburn was outstanding with 33 points and 13 rebounds, and they dominated the Minnesota Gophers at home. Then the Illini go on the road at Rutgers and suffer a 91-88 loss. They give the Rutgers Scarlet Knights 91 points. And so in the Illini's three losses this year, there's been a disturbing trend that has developed. Opponents' free throws, opponents' field goal percentage shooting, and fouls committed by the Illini. So if you look at all three games, Baylor, they were 15 to 24 from the free throw line. Not good conversion, but they got to the line 24 times. Missouri was 26 of 31 from the free throw line. That was the difference in the game that allowed Missouri to win that basketball game, even though they had foul trouble of their own. And then the Rutgers game, Rutgers shot only 25 of 36, but they got to the line 36 times. You can't win on the road in any quality conference, putting an opponent on the free throw line 36 times. And then field goal percentage defense, Baylor shot 46%, pretty good from the field. Missouri was 47, and Rutgers was 47%. You're not going to beat quality opponents allowing that type of field goal percentage to your opponents when they're coming at you. So free throws, opposing team's field goal percentage, and then also fouls. Kofi had four fouls against Baylor. Rest of the team was okay, but Kofi got in foul trouble, and that diminished his ability to be effective on the floor. In the Missouri game, six of seven players that played double-digit minutes had four fouls or more. Think about that for a second. Six players had four fouls or more. The Illini and Brad Underwood like to pride themselves on having some depth playing multiple guys, but when six of your players have four fouls with double-digit minutes played, that's a recipe for disaster, i.e. the loss at Missouri. And then in the loss against Rutgers, the starting five, four of the five players had four fouls or more. Andre Curbelo fouled out with 16 minutes played. So what this indicates to me is that the Illini are fouling too much. They're too handsy. They're going to have to adjust their defensive strategy when they go up against elite teams, because you can't put elite teams on the foul line like that. I never fouled out in 16 minutes. I fouled out of maybe one or two college games, and I played 32 to 35 minutes a game. And I was defensive player of the year. So I know a thing or two about playing defense. The Illini foul way too much. And so they're going to have to really shore that up if they're going to compete for what a lot of us think could be a Big Ten championship and also a trip to the Final Four possibly. So the warts are showing up early for the Illini, but this is good because they have time to correct those. They have time to address those. And in a competitive Big Ten conference, they're going to see so many different styles and ways that teams come at them that they will be battle tested if they can improve in these areas. So this week, they've got to go to Penn State, a Penn State team that forces a ton of turnovers. They're one of the best in the country at doing so. They're undersized. They don't have a lot of size. And so I think the Illini, with a veteran backcourt with Io, Trent, DeMonte, then you throw in Adam Miller, Andre Curbelo, I think they can hold their turnovers down. Penn State likes to pressure. They like to scramble you. They like to speed you up. I think the Illini can handle that pressure. And like I mentioned, they really don't have a lot of size nor depth up front. John Hara he's a battler. He'll bang Kofi and Georgie Bishanisvili up front. I just don't think that Penn State, when you get past Hara, then there's Trent Buttrick, which is, he's more of a spot-up three-point shooter, doesn't look to score in the post, can defend a little bit. But Penn State's been playing Tim Bela, who's a big freshman, but as a freshman, he can get in foul trouble. So I think the Illini can do fairly well against Penn State. Even though this game is on the road, I like the Illini in this one. The Illini then have Indiana at home on Saturday. This is going to be an interesting matchup. I just finished covering the Hoosiers in their victory over Butler. And what the Hoosiers do well is they get the ball in the paint and they get to the free throw line. So for the fact that the Hoosiers can draw fouls on a foul-happy Illini, this could be an issue for Illinois. If they cannot correct their fouling in this Indiana game, this will be a problem. Trayce Jackson-Davis gets to the free throw line better than anybody in the Big Ten Conference, including Garza of Iowa. So Trayce Jackson-Davis is going to get to the line 10 to 14 times a game. That's just what he does. He puts a lot of pressure on the defense. How can the Illini combat this? Also, Armand Franklin is shooting the ball extremely well. The last three games, he's probably shot the ball from three as well as anybody in the Big Ten Conference. So the Hoosiers have nice balance with Aljamie Durham, Rob Fennessy, Armand Franklin on the perimeter, as well as Race Thompson and Trayce Jackson-Davis up front. Now, with Joey Brunk of the Hoosiers being out, the Hoosiers don't have a lot of depth up front. This is where the Illini, if they can stay out of foul trouble guarding Trayce Jackson-Davis, can fare well. I like the Illini in this one. This one will be a little closer than Illini fans would prefer, but the fact that the Illini are at home, and I think they'll come in with some, you know, feeling good about themselves because they will have taken care of Penn State on the road, hopefully worked on their foul situation, not fouling opponents as much. I like them at home against Indiana, but Illini fans, this will be a close one, but I like Io DeSumo down the stretch and the Illini making the right decisions to get the victory at home. Let me know what you think. Hit me, send me an email, stephen.bardo@gmail.com. That's stephen.bardo@gmail.com. Or go to my website, stephenbardo.com. That'll do it for this edition of the Flyin' Illini Report. I'll come back to you next Monday with more news, insight, and predictions on how the Illini will do in that week. Until next time, y'all, peace!